Hi, everybody. Rhys Davids with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Ohio State's played like the number one team in the country so far this season. They deserve every accolade they've received up to this point. You know how this deal works. One misstep, one mistake, one faceplant, and everything you've worked for goes down the tube. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
What's going on, guys? Kobe with Babe Gaming. I'm back here bringing you guys some more NCAA Football 14 Dynasty Mode with my coach, Babe Gaming. You see, we are Ohio State. What happened to Troy? What happened to Maryland? That's right, guys. We did leave Troy after a not-so-great season. We finished right around 7-5. We almost took a couple head coach jobs at some smaller schools. And we kind of waited around till the end of the coaching carousel, and that's when the defense coordinator job opened up for Ohio State. I started uploading this series on my channel every single week, every single game, some recruiting. So if you guys are a fan of this series, you definitely got to swing by and check that out. But you see, Wisconsin's quarterback goes in the end zone with a rushing touchdown. He kept it off of the read option, went in for a score, and Wisconsin's going to strike first, but hold on, they're calling for a booth review. So let's get another look at this. He looked kind of like he was in. That angle, you can't really tell. The ball could have crossed right there. You never know. We need some better angles here. Okay, here we go. I think his teammate bumped him back. Number 16 right there. I don't know, guys. What do you guys think?
The ruling on the field is reversed.
All right, so the ruling on the field is reversed. It is not a touchdown, yet they are still on the one-yard line. Can we make a stop? We can't. And they get in on the very next play on first down. The running back gets into the end zone, picks up the touchdown. So Wisconsin's going to take a 7-0 lead here over us. Our offense does answer. Tying it up 7-7, and now their running back is taking off, picking up a huge gain, 27 yards on the play. Tompkins scanning the field, tossing over the right. He had two men there. I thought they were going to get tangled up, but one does take it, catches the ball, and tiptoes out of bounds. Now right there, we should have had an interception, but a nice bat down. Still take a bat down now on 3rd and 10. Scan the field, and he hits his wide receiver, star wide receiver, Darius Nelson, and he hits it for the first down. They can't get anything to go on first down or second down, so here on third down, they get their running back out to the outside, and Stanford Jackson's going to go in for his second touchdown of the day. Now Jackson, busting tackles, but he's going to finally be dragged down after 4 yards. Quarterback's going to keep it on the read option again, breaking tackles and picking up a first down. We're going to have to put a stop to that read option. Now Jackson back out here. He's stumbling, but finally gets taken down after 6 yards. Tompkins scan the field, hits Edwards across the middle. And Edwards breaking tackles, finally goes down, picking up 11 yards on the play. Nice little game. Wisconsin's marching. We need to put a stop to this. They hit Daniels. Daniels picking up 9 yards. What the heck? We got to do something. They are just marching on us. They have quite the rushing offense. And they have always been known for their offensive line, their rushing offense. But we got to come up with that interception. Come on, Cleveland. We're batting down all these balls that could be picked off. So now they did sell for a field goal. And now it's 17-14. Their quarterback is going to hit Hartman over the middle. But he's not going to be able to pick up the first down. We do make a third down stop. And that's going to send us into the second half. So out here in the second half, Wisconsin gets the ball first. But look at him get popped. The defense coordinator, Coach Babe Gaming, told his defense, you know, at halftime, hey, we got to stop this run. Lay on those heavy hits. We're going to send some blitzes. Just pop them. Make them know who they're messing with. Maybe scare them away from running the ball a little bit. Now that read option, we definitely got to stop. He picks up 8 yards right there, but not a first down. But on the next play, Jackson hits a hole, and Jackson's picking up the first down for Wisconsin. Tompkins keeping on the read option, and now we're getting the hang of it. He goes down for a negative 3 yards on the play. So we have a 21-17 lead here over Wisconsin. We need another stop, and they hit their man, Edwards. He's been huge today, and he gets another tiptoe catch here on the sideline. What a play. Second and two, Jackson up the middle. And they only needed two, but he picks up six, picking up the first down. Tompkins is going down. He's getting sacked, but come on. How do we not fall on that fumble? We're still bringing the pressure. Second and 17, and he hits his wide receiver, Hartman, for the touchdown on the very next play. 33-yard touchdown. What a play. So they are taking the 24-21 lead here over Ohio State. In Ohio State, we got to step it up for our home crowd. So now, right there, Jackson picking up 3 yards. He does pick up the first down. And right now, we're looking at this like, okay, we got about 4.5 minutes. Coming down to 4.5 minutes, we can make a stop. We only give up 5 yards. Then on third and one, we give up a first down. And Jenkins gets a reception, picking up first down. We're down to about 3.5 minutes. Daniels gets pounded in the backfield, and our defense is hyped. 3rd and 9, this is a must stop. And right there, they're hitting Jackson, and he's going to fall on the first down. Oh, it's 4th and inches. And so they are going to have to either punt it or kick it. Either way, they do not get it, and Ohio State does get the ball. So now down by 3, we do need to make another stop. Our offense did not do anything after we made that last stop. So now we do force a punt right there, and our offense does score, 28-24. Our offense finally answers on the second stop that we needed late in the game. They score with about 44 seconds left to go in the game. And now Wisconsin's under some pressure. They only got 33 seconds left. It is 4th and 4 coming up, and they got some pressure. They need to convert. They need to get down the field if they want to score, and they need a touchdown. They do convert right there. Darius Nelson gets the first down. They can't get a field goal. They need a touchdown. Our defensive line batting the ball down right there. Theo Outlaw doing his thing, batting the pass down. So now 4th and 10. The quarterback goes down with a sack. And that's going to be your ball game. Ohio State is going to win this game. What a sack to end the game on 4th and 10. Their quarterback felt the pressure. He couldn't get rid of the ball. And our defense is hyped. They came through in the clutch. You know, we definitely had to rely on our offense to make that final drive, put us up by 4 points, and they came through as well. So, what a great team performance here for Ohio State. We almost get upset by number 24, Wisconsin, and we'd have been starting the season off 0-1 in the conference. So, definitely a must-needed win, and we definitely played very well. Definitely proud of our defense. But hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, comment down in the comment section below, guys. I want to thank you guys for stopping by, checking out my video today. Big shout out to my good friend Matt, Not As Fan, for letting me upload, guys. I'll see you guys on the next episode. Peace.